No guarantee of this video, brother.
Because I don't have resources to have proper things. Shafqat, okay, he remembers me of what we have been trying to do 12 years ago in Islamic League, which to create future leaders from the young graduates, from the young Islamic workers, from the school leavers. At that time, 2004. And I'm very happy that it's happening now. Doesn't matter when it happens, but it does matter because it's happening, which is very good. One thing which we need to understand is the best information to design our project is the information comes from the needy, not only from our office workers. That's why we have to find a way of involving the orphans, the widows, displaced, and refugees, because they are the people who reflect their needs to us. The most successful project is based on their input, not on our input, not on the HQ input, not on the desk officer input, not on the director's input. And this is something which you need to learn at this time, because in the good old days we were just doing everything. Fundraising, street work, cleaning up, and you were jack of all trade. You know what jack of all trade?
Yeah.
Master of none. Okay? But now you have to have speciality and super speciality and sub speciality and sub speciality and super speciality, which have to be specializing. And the success story of Islamic Leaf was in the quick response to any disaster globally. The quick response. No Saturday, no Sunday, no evening, off time, nothing. I remember Pakistan earthquake, when was that? 2005?
Yeah.
2005.
End of 2004.
October 2005. Thank you, sir. I'm Pakistani. I'm Pakistani. He doesn't know where I come from. We decided when the British government made a pledge of £100,000. The American government made a pledge for $100,000. Islamic Leaf on Saturday pledged £2 million. All the media thought that we are mad, that we do not know what we are talking about, that we are a bunch of amateurs. Okay? And when they interviewed us on BBC, we told them, have you visited Kashmir? No. So how can you pledge $100,000 or £100,000 or $500,000? And they told us, why you pledge £2 million? We told them, because we know Kashmir, know the mountains of Kashmir. But at the peak or the top of each mountain, there's many, many villages. Once you shave the mountain, people will be dead on the top of this mountain in these villages. Within a week, we discovered that 90,000 people, right, were killed in the earthquake. So we're ahead of the British government, we're ahead of the American government, and we're ahead of the international humanitarian community, because we know the place. We went to the place where nobody else was there since the late 90s, because Kashmir was a no-go area, a no-go area. With NOC, you can't go there unless you have an NOC, which is security clearance. This is a message for you. You learn here a lot. Maybe Brother Majid? Huh? Oh, where did Majid come from? Come from me. I keep calling people names. Huh? Majid and Jalil are names of Allah as well. You're still inside. Brother Abdul Jalil, he can give you a good policy papers to follow, but we want you also to bend your back to have backache, to have headache, to have sweating arms and ears and eyes. You know when your eyes sweat? It shed tears. When you are with those people. So when you come back to Brother Majid, you'll be, sorry, Brother Abdul Jalil, you'll be like the hoopoe bird. You know hoopoe bird? The bird. The old hoodwood. Hoopoe? Came back to King Solomon. And King Solomon, he was telling him, where is this bird? I'm going to chop his neck or torture him because he's not in the meeting. You are late to the high level meeting. So this is King Solomon and you are the hoopoe bird, okay? But you came very, very proud of what knowledge you have from the field. And you stood in front of King Solomon. How confident this little miserable bird standing in front of the king of the kings. So I came to you from Sheba, where I found great news that you do not know it, King Solomon. What did you tell me at that time? You took him in Sabah and never in Yaqeen. So he came with the good news because he was a field worker. The bird wants to look for water, but he found the greater news that those people do not worship God, they worship the moon or the sun or whatever you call it. So this is your role. The right facts is from the field and from the people who are suffering. And what we say in Arabic, Al-Haga Umm Al-Ikhtira'a, need is the mother of innovation. That's right. Need is the mother of innovation. So you go where the people are, so be the great of the greatest. With Brother Majid.
Abdul Majid is here.
Now we congratulate you for having 3 months with us. And Brother Abdul Jalil now will come and stand up and greet you.
Put your name.
We
will
greet you. No, in public, because now you come forward.